السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Peace be upon you, ladies and gentlemen. I am honored to welcome His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, Prime Minister, Vice President, and Ruler of Dubai. May God protect him. I would also like to welcome their highnesses, their excellencies, and all the guests. I would like to welcome you to this main session within the second government summit, during which His Highness Sheikh Mansour bin Zayed Al-Nahyan, Deputy Prime Minister and Minister of Presidential Affairs, will be speaking. His Highness Sheikh Mansour will tackle the topic of partnerships and innovation in government services. It is the government of the United Arab Emirates, this government that is always want to be first. It's a government that has invested all of its capabilities for the sake of the country and the citizens. This is why we are among the most happiest citizens in the world. This also requires exceptional citizens who believe in loyalty to the country and the leadership. Let us all, ladies and gentlemen, welcome His Highness Sheikh Mansour bin Zayed Al Nahyan. The floor is yours, Your Highness. We are very happy to have you here during this second edition of the government summit. We would like Your Highness to start with a series of questions. The first question is, the cabinet of the UAE is the executive body of the Council of Ministers. It monitors the work of the Federal Cabinet Committee and studies the solution in order to improve government services provided to citizens. Your Highness, in your position, how are the priority issues that are on the agenda of 2014?
In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful, Your Highness, Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, ladies and gentlemen, let me firstly convey to you the greetings of His Highness, the President of the United Arab Emirates. May Allah preserve him. And his wishes for you to have a successful conference. Before 1 year ago, almost 1 year ago, in this conference, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid said, you always strive for the first position, because we, myself and my people, must always strive to be first. After almost 1 year, the United Arab Emirates, and Dubai in particular, won the most prestigious exhibition, namely Expo 2020. This is a clear proof that the UAE is striving for excellence. And of course, the UAE is also striving for excellence at all levels, internationally and locally. And this has always been an incentive for the leadership, the citizens, and the residents to always seek to be the first. Mr. Abdulrahim, before answering your question, I think we should maybe remember some important aspects which we should focus on. Making the citizen happy, reaching out to the citizen at all levels, then asking leaders, people in charge, ministers, to follow up with the work done directly and be on the ground in the field. This is what we asked from them 1 year ago. But today, it is important that there should be standards that can be used to assess the activities of the ministers on the ground and reaching out to the citizens directly. As to your question, Brother Abdul Rahim, the Services Ministerial Council holds meetings mainly prior to every meeting of the cabinet. We don't take decisions in our meetings. However, we do discuss all issues that relate to all ministries, and it's an open discussion, a lengthy one, a clear discussion, and a frank one. And every minister and every official express their views clearly, and then we agree. Once we reach an agreement, it is submitted to the Council Ministers, and then His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid, the Prime Minister, adopts the decision. So there is a condition to be respected, namely to have discussions about all issues and then submit any proposal to the decision makers to adopt the proposal. And we do have a plan in the UAE under the leadership of His Highness Sheikh Khalifa and His Highness Sheikh Mohammed, thanks to a clear vision. Every minister and every official must have a clear vision in order to plan future steps.
Your Highness, financing the government services through the budget and the contribution of local governments, we know that you are presiding over the UAE body for investment. Can you explain the role of this body in supporting the UAE?
This body was established maybe 6 or 7 years ago, thanks to the directives of His Highness the President and His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid. Currently, this institution attracts surplus from the federal government and invests in portfolios of the Emirates Investment Institution. As to the funds and shares and assets of our institution, we provide or use them as a support for the federal budget. This is very important. We want to diversify the sources of income for our state and for our budget. We want to have investment institutions that can be active, well managed, for to secure our future, and of course, this may also result in profits for the state.
Your Highness, based on the initiative of the President of the UAE, he wanted the citizens to benefit from these initiatives. They wanted the citizens to live in stability and to ensure family stability. What are the main projects and programs implemented by His Highness in the field of infrastructure?
The initiative of His Highness, the President, is based on many sectors. And the field, which I was and I'm so proud of, is the health care sector and the building of a hospital. When, along with His Highness, the ruler of Umm al-Qiwin visited the Sheikh Khalifa Hospital in Umm al-Qiwin, the hospital was inaugurated 4 or 5 months back. When we visited the hospital, we met officials, doctors, nurses who are nationals in a big part. And this is a source of pride for us, because there are initiatives that are really the fruit of the citizens, of the children of the UAE, in a very important sector, namely the healthcare sector, which is vital for the UAE. And at the same time, this is a good experience, because it is the fruit of a partnership with the private sector, a partnership between the private sector and the initiative of His Highness the President. The qualified citizens were recruited. These are people who were specialized in certain fields, and this is very important. As to the infrastructure, namely roads or popular houses or the improvement of certain regions, I was honored to accompany His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid in following up on the Manatak projects for houses to be built for nationals. And we, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid and myself, went to follow up on the work done. And the houses built are sustainable, really. These houses will last for a long time, because in the past, when a house was built, after 6-7 years, the house required new maintenance. However, we have overcome this concept, because there are an assessment and standards that are implemented by entrepreneurs. Entrepreneurs need to focus mainly on sustainability of the houses that are built, because once the citizen moves in his house, he must live in his house for a long time.
There are projects underway. Is that correct? We have many projects. We have a program for the coming 5 years and another long-term project for 10 years. The big projects require time and requires a bigger number of human resources. I would like to thank their highnesses, the rulers of the UAE, for their hard work and honorable work. They were very cooperative in the context of this initiative. They gave us guidance when it comes to the residential areas and the distribution of houses. These factors are very important. I would like to focus on other areas apart from the residential houses. We have the sector of dams in eastern areas. We have a focus on maritime and land agriculture. This is why the maritime sector is very important, and we focus mainly on the ports and on the maintenance of the different components of these ports. We have been able to build 25 ports with a cost of 86 million dirhams to support the maritime sector. Water is also very important in the UAE, and we have a scarcity in drinking water. Dams, of course, help in providing drinking water for the agricultural sector, and also helps in planting some products which help the farmers and other citizens in the UAE. The other aspect is related to the Bedouins who live in desert areas in eastern and northern Emirates. We have implemented a number of projects in this area. Of course, the fields are numerous, especially in the field of camel races. They are very interested in this field, so we have constructed race courts and organized permanent programs, and this has encouraged many people to specialize in certain maritime, agricultural, and land areas. What about the mechanism of operating these ports and projects? We have two main mechanisms in terms of hospitals. We have a bid for projects. And we have another part, which is the part of operating the infrastructure. We have companies which provide bids in order to manage hospitals and medical institutions, and which abide by standards in order to satisfy the citizens. If we have a certain number of complaints against a hospital, we discuss these complaints with the operator in order to make sure that the operator is always under stress and that he delivers the necessary outcome. When it comes to residential houses, this is under the control of the local emirates. We go through discussions with these emirates in order to agree on operating these institutions. Now we will talk about the initiative of His Highness the President of the UAE to form a committee for the settlement of the citizens' loans, outstanding loans. This was very useful for many citizens in the UAE who were not able to settle their loans. And fortunately, they were able to recover their family and financial stability. Your Highness, can you tell us a little bit about the achievements of this initiative? This is an important question, but what is more important is awareness. We should have awareness at the level of the local media. I think that the local media hasn't been very performant at this level. Of course, awareness is very important. And consequently, the instability of banks is a problem because some users, some citizens, do not know or are not aware of the process of calculating the interests. The loans in 2012 or the citizens who benefited from this fund are estimated at 1,500 citizens, and this is equivalent to 1,300,000,000. In 2013, the number of beneficiaries from the fund was 2,000 citizens, which is equivalent to 2,050,000,000 dirhams. Consequently, the number of beneficiaries is decreasing because we are witnessing a better response from the banks and the banking sector in general. And in this context, allow me to thank all the banks and specifically the bank which cooperated with the initiative of His Highness, the President of the UAE, to settle the loans of citizens, which is the Commercial Bank of Abu Dhabi, or Abu Dhabi Commercial Bank, ADCB. The Abu Dhabi Commercial Bank has settled 21 million dirhams and has been very cooperative. And at the same time, we are looking forward to see similar initiatives at the level of other national banks in the context of settling the outstanding loans of UAE citizens. Your Highness, if you want to convey a message to the young generation today so that they avoid the loans and the burden of loans, what's this message? Mr. Abdulrahim, my recommendation or advice to the young generation is that these loans are granted for the benefit of the user or of the citizen. We know that the bank has certain responsibilities and duties. However, if there is a lack of awareness among the users, who are the persons benefiting from the loans, I'll give you an example about a citizen who has a loan on his credit card. The limit of the credit card, let's say, is 100,000. The bank has put it at 580,000. Is it possible to allow or to exploit or to allow the citizen to benefit from 580,000 in this way? I think that a study has been conducted in order to establish institutions responsible for monitoring bank and financial institutions further. The Minister of Finance is aware of that. And I think that we are on the way to monitoring local and foreign banks. We have a weakness in or weaknesses in some laws. We should improve these laws for the sake of our country, of the UAE. My advice and recommendation to the UAE citizens is do not take a loan unless you are in a dire need for a loan. Take a loan in order to establish your own business, and if you are aware of all the risks, I think that the citizen should be fully aware of all the aspects of this matter, and I think that the media can play an important role in raising awareness about financial guidance and loans. Your Highness, if you want to send a message to the banks, what's your recommendation for the UAE banks? I think that the banks have been dealing with this for almost three or four years. If there are no legal regulations imposed on the banks and if the powers are not clear, the bank cannot succeed. During the previous period, we have addressed many recommendations and held many meetings with the banks. Most of the banks have cooperated positively. However, there should be regulations and laws, and the central bank is currently studying the financial situation. Your Highness, now we will move to the initiative of His Highness the President of the UAE in order to enhance the participation of the national cadres through APSHAR. A number of programs were launched in order to increase the participation of national cadres in the UAE market and increase the competitiveness of the UAE market. Your Highness, what are your expectations in terms of the initiative APSHAR? APSHAR is a partnership with the private sector. And here I would like to thank all our partners in the private sector for their cooperation and for their seriousness in training and recruiting. And here, I would like to say that I have met with excellent and distinguished students in universities in the UAE. These students were very excited about this initiative. I would like to thank them for this meeting. They asked me many questions. They were hesitating about working with the public sector and private sector. Of course, there are many opportunities in the public sector today. But if a student graduates and works in the private sector for 1 or 2 years, he will benefit or she will benefit a lot. And this will open doors for future opportunities. And these doors maybe would be individual businesses. We encourage businesses in order to contribute to the national economy, because we think that every person who is specialized in his own field is a fortune for the UAE. Consequently, these experiences are important, and I think that it is necessary for the citizens to work for both the public and the private sector. The initiative of APSHR has been launched a few years back, and 4,000 UAE nationals since then have been appointed in the private sector and have been doing well. I'll give you an example. About the Bureau of His Highness the President's Missions. This Bureau sends students or UAE students to foreign universities outside the UAE. When this Bureau was initially established, we received a UAE female student. She wanted to apply to go to the United States. Her application was accepted because she was a distinguished student. She studied in the United States of America, and she specialized in medicine. Of course, medicine requires academic studies and training. After 15 years, she came back to the UAE and she asked, in which institution can I work? In which hospital can I work? We told her, you will not be working for the public sector. She was surprised. She said, I have been in the United States for 15 years studying, and I can't work for the public sector. We decided to empower her and let her establish her own business. She established a company in the United States, and here I would like to say that her name is Dr. Hawa Al-Mansouri. She now will be giving you a brief about her experience and the specialization. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Peace be upon you. Allow me first and foremost to thank His Highness Sheikh Mansour bin Zayed Al-Nahyan for inviting me to attend the 2014 Government Summit. I am honored to be among you here today in this very important Government Summit. I have started my path with a scholarship. I was able to go to the United States to specialize in medicine. I have worked as a physician at the George Washington Hospital. I was the first non-American student to graduate from George Washington, and I have a degree in internal medicine, and I'm working on my new business. I have developed a new pipeline, which is different from the current scopes that are being used today, and thanks to the support of His Highness Sheikh Mansour bin Zayed Al Nahyan, I have established a company that develops scopes. And today, this is being adopted by the FDA, and I think that we will be able to produce this product in the near future in the UAE by a UAE company. Here, I would like to thank the leadership of the United Arab Emirates for their long-standing support, and I would like to ask God to help me to help my country thrive. Thank you.
Your Highness, let's now, if I may, move on to the Arab Spring. In the light of the challenges faced by the Arab world, we've noticed, especially in the UAE, a close relationship between the leadership and the people to fight any foreign interventions or any extreme ideas. Your Highness Sheikh Mansour, what are your remarks about this theme? I think those who used the word spring were in a haste to use this term, actually. Thank God, the United Arab Emirates, throughout history, and the UAE people is always supportive of the UAE leadership because the UAE leaders are so close to the people without any protocols. This is a very important aspect. Our experience in the UAE is a realistic one. We don't want to exaggerate, actually. Our leadership reaches out to the citizens. Our leaders visit citizens. Citizens visit our leaders. So this has really created a very strong bonds between the leadership and the people. As to the Arab Spring, which some Arab countries witnessed, we do know that these revolutions are popular revolutions. However, once a revolution takes place, or once a term is coined, I believe there should be positive outcome for such developments. We are so sorry that the situations in the Arab countries have reached this level, this status, and we all pray to Allah to help the Arab countries to settle down, to stabilize, and I hope Arab countries will go back to the previous situation and in a better way. I'm not talking here about the leadership, but I'm talking about helping Arab countries to grow, to be closer to one another. And this conference, in my view, is important because it is important because we have among us Arabs. Arabs are welcome in the UAE, and we do really exchange our experience with theirs. And we also want to take advantage of their ideas, their experiences. We have implemented some schemes, and we want to benefit from the Arabs' experiences, and we want also to make our experiences available to them. I thank all those who have organized this second government summit and who have allowed our brothers from Arab countries to attend, to come here to discuss their ideas and views in a practical way. And I hope the outcomes of this conference will benefit everybody here. Your Highness, the Abu Dhabi Development Fund contributes by 22% in external UAE aid since 2012. As you know, Your Highness, the total amount is over 5 billion. So what is the policy you adopt within the fund in providing development aid? The Abu Dhabi Development Fund supports loans, soft loans, long-term loans that are given to friendly countries, to neighboring countries, and to countries in need, countries going through development projects. So these are soft loans because the interest rate in the first 5 years is zero, and after the first years, there are interest rates that are implemented, and they vary from one country to the other. However, the Abu Dhabi Investment Fund, and following the instructions of His Highness the President and His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed, the Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi, the funds have increased to $16 billion. And this has led the way to the implementation of development projects in the UAE. It is important that the fund can also fund development schemes in the UAE. On the other hand, we have the Emirates Development Bank. This bank, in essence, was the UAE Industrial Bank and the Emirates Real Estate Bank. Both banks were merged, and His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid has instructed that this bank provides finance for development projects in the UAE too. And I believe in 2014 or 2015, the fund will support the first projects in the UAE. Let's, if I may, Your Highness, move on to the next question related to the federal law about national service or the National Reserve Service, which the cabinet adopts. And this was welcomed greatly by the UAE youth, as they regard this as a sacred mission for every UAE young man or young woman. What can you say about this? As I said, I met today university students. 70 of them were ladies, and they were complaining really about this law because girls are not comprised in this election. They want UAE girls really want to be accepted before UAE young men. So the draft law is so important, and indeed, students, young students from a given age, will have to join the military service. However, girls will then be, it will be optional for girls. This project really is important, and as it does contribute to the provision of skills to the UAE young man to acquire knowledge or to acquire experience while working in the army. So as a young man, he must learn how to be disciplined. And it is very important because as a young man, it's good for a man to be enrolled in the army, to be educated, how to be disciplined, to be respectful, to serve the nation, to serve the society. This is really very important. And of course, many UAE families, namely mothers, were so happy because they tell, I would say that we can provide a good opportunity for the children. Your Highness, there is a cooperation between the private sector and the public sector in the provision of services, in the management of services, and in the funding of services. There are many aspects of this relationship between the private sector and public sector, namely in the water and electricity service and post and health care. How can you evaluate this partnership, this cooperation with the private sector? Regarding our cooperation and collaboration with the private sector, this is an ongoing process, and we have entrusted the federal institution in charge of electricity and water to develop the infrastructure wholly in all the seven UAE Emirates. And His Excellency, the Minister of Energy, is really now doing a great job in developing and upgrading the infrastructure in the field of electricity and water. Nevertheless, we need to be aware that the ratio of the increase of demand per year is very high in the UAE. So, this increase is not 5% or 7%. It has reached, in some instances, to 12%. Hence, we have coordinated our efforts with some Emirates in a more in a clearer way. We have provided for the federal establishment or institution to be given at least a plan for 10 years, at least, where the federal institution will provide water and electricity to all sectors of the society in the Emirate. And then the ratio has to be well defined, because these high ratios of increase really did not suit the requirements of the Water and Electricity Federal Authority. So we need really to insist on this coordination, which is important, and it was a good step forward. As to the UAE, to the infrastructure in water and electricity in the UAE, it has been renovated in 2013, 2012, and in 2014 also. We do have projects for the development, for renovation of the infrastructure in the water and electricity sector. This is very important, because in the coming 20 years, the demand for water electricity will increase, and we're working on this now.
Your Highness, I think that we are out of questions now, but I think that whenever you are here, we should talk about your interest in sports, in sports festivals, in terms of horses, camels. What's the message that you would like to convey through these sports? First, I would like to talk about the popular sports here in the United Arab Emirates, the camel races. Camel racing is a very important sport. 10 or 8 years ago, in the United Arab Emirates, each jockey used to practice camel racing. We have heard many reservations from different institutions. We heard that the popular sport in the UAE is the camel racing. Because this is a very popular sport in the UAE. So this has led to banning jockeys in the first popular sport in the UAE. Western companies have set the weight of jockeys to 30 kilograms or 25 kilograms. This did not convince the people in the UAE. Moreover, a citizen has created today the 1.5 kilograms jockey. This 1.5 kilos jockey did not convince many people. Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid called me and told me that there is someone who's against this idea. So what do you think? Shall I send him to you? I told him so he should first try this for 1 month at least. And after this trial period of 1 month, for 2 or 3 years, we held a meeting with the same group, the group who was originally opposing the idea. We told them that we have reached an agreement, a certain settlement with international organizations, and we would go back to the initial standards. So we heard a big opposition. They wanted the new standards to be applied. What I would like to say today is that the challenge is great and is part of our nature. We like challenges. We like adventures. Our life is full of challenges every day. And the biggest challenge was to convince the Bedouins to be interested in camel racing, in a sport that is very close to their nature. And fortunately, and thank God, they have accepted this kind of sport, which has been introduced by UAE citizens. This kind of sport has developed over the years, and every year we are launching new initiatives under the guidance of His Highness Sheikh Mohammed. This year we were in Meknas, and we have agreed to introduce a new system. That allows to differentiate the kinds of camels through SIM cards and identify their type. And I think that we are going in the right direction, in the direction of improving and developing this popular sport so it can become a professional sport. And I think that the camel owners are today more aware of our initiatives and are aware of its importance and of the righteousness of this path. To answer your question about the horse races in the United Arab Emirates are an old hobby, and His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid has encouraged greatly this sport. And whenever we are ahead of we are not ahead of these efforts. We hear our family members calling upon us to be at the forefront of these races. At the same time, I would like to thank His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid for his support to horse racing and for his keenness on this popular sport. And I think that he has a sportsmanship in his own nature. He has this sense of encouragement, of sportsmanship, and I think that this is great, and I would like to thank you for these characteristics. And I think that here we have to conclude this session, but I have a final question, or I would like to ask you to address a final message. I would like here to address all the attendees of this summit today. We are meeting all together, and we would like to benefit from your experiences, from your hard work, and we would like to cooperate with you in all fields and sectors. Consider that the United Arab Emirates is your second country, your second nation, and that you are most welcome here in the United Arab Emirates. May God protect you all. I think that you have an initiative that you would like to launch during this summit. If you allow me, Your Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid, we have an initiative, a new initiative, which allows all members of the UAE society to cooperate in proposing new ideas and initiatives and in coordinating all together. We have launched a site, and we would like to invite you to inaugurate it. We would like to ask His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum to come to the podium to inaugurate the new initiative of His Highness Sheikh Mansour bin Zayed. اهتمام for social innovation or societal innovation.